Hi, good evening everyone, and thank you so much for joining this session today. Before we start, just a few administrative things. So the session is scheduled for around 45 minutes, and after that we can have a short Q&A for 15-20 minutes. So please post your questions to the live chat and we can take them up at the end of the session. And also, if you're comfortable, please probably like to see all your faces. And please make sure that your mi microphone is on mute. My name is Anurag, and I'm a student member of the Think India Leadership Forum, and I'll be the moderator for today's session. Thank you again for joining, all of you. So Think India is a pan-India initiative that brings together the best minds of the country and creates a forum of students, researchers, alumni, and faculty members from premier institutes across India. And one such forum that was formed is this one, the Leadership Development Forum, which was created with a vision that more youth leaders can be encouraged, and also the understanding of leadership can be developed among such individuals. And today we have the very first event of our session, which is titled Leadership Lessons from Chanakya. And we are very pleased to have Dr. Radhakrishnan Pillai, sir, as our first guest speaker for this session. We welcome you, sir. So
Thank
just to
you,
give
Laura.
you an introduction, thank you, sir. Just to give you an introduction about Dr. Radhakrishnan Pillai, sir. He is the best-selling author of over 14 books, such as Corporate Chanakya on Leadership, Corporate Chanakya on Management. He has done an extensive research on Kautilya's Arthashastra, the well-known book on management written in the 4th century BC, and has a master's degree in Sanskrit. He is the deputy director of the Chanakya Institute of Inst International Institute of Leadership Studies in University of Mumbai, and his first book, The Corporate Chanakya, has been on the bestseller list since its launch in 2010, and has been used as a textbook in various business schools in India and abroad. He has been awarded the prestigious Sardar Patel International Award 2009 for his research and contribution in the field of management and industrial development. On behalf of Think India Leadership Forum, I would like to welcome you, sir, to today's talk session. As a leader, there are certain career hacks, skills, and qualities which we are required to have. And in today's session, we will learn about these qualities as per Chanakya. And so I'll request Dr. Pillai to please enlighten us with these leadership lessons from Chanakya. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Mir, and the whole organizing team. I hope I'm audible. Am I audible? Want to
Sir,
reconfirm? Yeah.
yes, sir,
Okay.
you're audible, sir. Yes, sir.
Thank you so much. First of all, congratulations on the Think India Leadership Forum. I've been associated with Think India already for so many years, so the whole team, because I've been able to travel so many premium institutes in India, IITs and IIMs across India, speaking at the same forum but at different campuses. Thank you so much. It's an honor to actually speak to the thinkers of the future of India. Institutes, you're smart, you're intelligent, and now I'm so glad we're talking about a subject called as leadership. You know what is Chanakya, but as they say, Chanakya includes subjects. And therefore, when I first got in touch with Chanakya's life, it was all about his life story, his historical work. Yes, so who was Chanakya? When did he live? What did he do? Etc., etc., etc. But later on, I discovered Chanakya is not just a historical person, he is a thinker. Think India. So he was thinking about India. And remember one thing, that you can be thinker at any level. So everybody thinks. So छोटा आदमी हो या बड़ा आदमी हो, छोटा व्यक्ति हो या बड़ा व्यक्ति हो, सब सोचते हैं. लेकिन जब लीडर सोचता है, when the leader thinks, then thing changes. Therefore, a Mahabharata says, "Yatha raja tatha praja." Raja kalasya karanam. Okay, a leader creates a complete era. And you may have a personal destiny, अपना नसीब कहते हैं ना, अपनी किस्मत, but you are having also the destiny of the right leader along with you. So, you know, all people die for a good leader. It is said every society, every samaj ka ek hi requirement hota hai. And that if you have a good leader, then that country is prosperous. People will not leave that country. In fact, Chanakya says that if you are not respected, if you're not getting money and, you know, appreciation in a place, leave that place, even if it is your Janma Bhumi, which is so dangerous, you know. But Chanakya was a practical philosopher, because wherever you are, if the leadership of that particular place is good, they will appreciate you. They will give you opportunities. In India, the same forum that we're talking about, you know, all the premium education institutions, in the 1960s onwards, we had a concept called as brain drain, isn't it? So a lot of people left India, and it's not that they were not patriotic. It is not that, you know, they did not want to do anything for India. The system was like this, that you felt, you know, there is no opportunities. I remember I was in IIT Bombay when I was in, and it was written on the wall, graffiti. It said very nicely, it is better to have brain drain rather than having brain in the drain. So it's a very powerful thing. It is better to have brain drain rather than having brain in the drain. So you must have seen that our country went through a kind of a leadership crisis. And when I say leadership crisis, I'm not just talking about political leadership crisis. I think we were all just a system of making more followers. We had the system of followership, not leadership. So agar aap koi college join karte ho, so it's all about study well, beta, do well, you'll get a good job, you'll go to America and you'll become successful. So that was the education system. The education system was not creating leaders. The education system was creating followers. Thanks to the British administration, their education system was actually an examination system. So, you know, you examine who is the right guy to work for my civil services so that that person can become a collector who will collect the taxes. The Britishers left us and we continued. I have a very good colleague in Mumbai University, Dr. Manjari Kamath. She is head of the history department. And once I was chatting with her, you know, she did her PhD from Cambridge. A very good professor. She came back to Mumbai. And she's part of Mumbai. Manjari, ma'am, you know, what are we doing? This whole bureaucracy that we have, system that we have, Britishers, you know, hum log koi decision hi nahi lete. During the Britishers' time, the decision was taken in England, implemented in India. So she laughed and said, yeah, yeah, Britishers created the system. We continue. And I'm not sure if we made it better or worse. So you have to understand one thing, that the time has come for our country to rise to not just a system, but a leadership system where everybody thinks like a leader, not a follower. Who is a follower? Who waits for orders, who waits for somebody else to take a decision and tell you what to do. And I'll tell you that mindset has to change, because I'm not telling you to take orders or give orders, but at least take decision for your own life, take charge. Leadership is about decisions for yourself and for others. Decision making is one of the most important qualities of a leader. So friends, with that, I would like to focus on today's topic. That is Chanakya and leadership. Chanakya's ideas on leadership. Interestingly, Chanakya was a Raj Guru. He was the guru of Rajas or leaders. That's exactly where I would like to draw upon one very important aspect. That what are the kind of things that he is speaking about that leaders should know? So I will not go into the life of Chanakya too much, because already available. I would suggest all of you read about him. Of course, I haven't done many books, but there are a lot of videos also available, series also available on Chanakya's life. Born in the 4th century BC, known as Kautilya Vishnugupta Chanakya, lived 2400 years ago. He defeated Alexander. He made Chandragupta Maurya the Emperor of India. All those stories, they're all there. But I would suggest that all of you should watch a series by Dr. Chandraprakash Dwivedi called Chanakya, which used to come in Doordarshan. It's available on YouTube, 47 episodes. You can download it or whatever, view it. It will give you a lot of perspective about the life of Chanakya. And also involved in a movie production Neeraj Pandey ji, some of you may be aware of Neeraj Pandey, is a very respected director who made movies like Wednesday, Baby, Dhoni, all those movies. So we are now making a movie with Ajay Devgan as the star cast, and the movie is called Chanakya, and I'm heading the research for it. Okay, so friends, I don't want to tell you the story and the whole biography of Chanakya, it's all there. But as you say, I'm not going to talk about the person, but I'm going to talk about the thought of the person. Chanakya ke vichar kya the? What is his particular ideas on leadership? Yes, please.
राधा सर, तो वॉइस ब्रेक हो रहा है ड्यू टू सम इंटरनेट प्रॉब्लम. आप है ना, आपका वीडियो बंद करके भी कर सकते हैं, वो फिर ऑडियो ठीक आएगा सर. अगर पॉसिबल हो तो कर सकते हैं.
ओके, सो बताइए अभी ऑडियो ठीक है, क्लियर है?
सर अभी भी नहीं है सर, वॉइस अभी ठीक नहीं है सर. ओके, जस्ट वेट फॉर 1 मिनट. ओके, हो इंटरनेट कनेक्शन सर एडजस्ट कर रहे हैं, हो जाएगा. ओके, कोई भी अपना माइक ऑन ना करे सर, हैं सर.
हेलो, आई एम ऑडिबल बेटर? हेलो,
यस सर, अभी ऑडिबल है.
या आई हैव चेंज माय इंटरनेट कनेक्शन. आई एम ऑडिबल एंड यू कैन सी मी आल्सो?
यस.
ओके, सो प्लीज स्टॉप कि देयर इज अ डिसकंटिन्यूटी, लेट मी नो. ओके, गणेश जी, कैन आई कंटिन्यू?
यस यस सर, यस सर.
Sorry yes, for sir. The yeah. Sorry for the technical issue. I'd like to just continue saying that there are two parts of Chanakya. One is the life of Chanakya, and the second is the teachings of Chanakya. And since all of you are thinkers, and the platform is Think India and also Leadership Forum, today I'm going to be speaking about his book called as Kautilya's Arthashastra, and another book of his called as Chanakya Niti. So, friends, I'll be putting up 5 ideas of leadership from Kautilya's Arthashastra. So before we get into Kautilya's Arthashastra, let me tell you about these two books that Chanakya wrote. And I would suggest every one of you to please read these two books at least once in your lifetime. Okay, so I'm just telling you, read it at least once in a lifetime. If you can read it 3 times, Kautilya Arthashastra, it is like a modern day constitution of any country. So when Chanakya made Chandragupta Maurya the leader, he realized just by making somebody a leader doesn't make him or her a leader. A good leader has to be trained to become a leader. And after getting the position, he needs guidance in leadership also. Raja banne ke baad kaise vyavahar karna, ye bhi seekhna padta hai. Aur raja banne ke baad ek rajguru lagta hai. And therefore, you know, in a country which got freedom, we have a constitution which tells us what to do and most important, what not to do. So Kautilya Arthashastra is a book which is a leadership manual. It got 6,000 sutras on leadership. So all the leaders study Arthashastra. Of course, it is 2,400 years old, but the principles of leadership are still constant. I'll be talking about that. So Arthashastra is a massive book, and I've been fortunate to study it, teach it, written so many books, did my PhD on that. But today I'll be sharing 5 points of leadership from the Arthashastra. Let me also introduce you to other book that Chanakya wrote, which is called Chanakya Niti. Chanakya Niti is different from Kautilya Arthashastra. It has got 350 sutras. So it is like watching a trailer and watching a movie. So if you have seen the whole movie Arthashastra, then Chanakya Niti is like, okay, samajh mein aa gaya. But let me tell you the objective. Chanakya Niti was written for the common man, praja. While Arthashastra was written for the masses. No, not for the masses, for the classes. So if you want to be a Raja, you have to read Arthashastra. But if you want to understand the Praja, you have to understand Chanakya Niti. Dono pad lena, samaj lena. Now coming back, what are the five things that I'm going to point out from Arthashastra? When you study Arthashastra, it's got 6,000 sutras of leadership divided into 15 books, 150 chapters and 180 sections. It's a volume, okay? But once you start studying it, saying that, you know, a leader needs to know so many topics, so many areas. And that's what Chanakya says, you know, the more you know, the better the leader you will be. You cannot be uninformed leader. You need to be informed and you should also be wise. Therefore, the ideal leader, according to Chanakya, is called as Raja Rishi. Remember this word, not just Raja, but the combination is of a Rishi, Raja plus Rishi. So he is a philosopher king, or I would say leader with a spiritual base. हमारे यहाँ पे जितने भी अच्छे राजा होके गए, who are respected, they were always Raja Rishis. And even though India formally got into democratic structure of governance in 1947, for thousands of years, we had a monarchy system. Remember that? We had princely states before we actually became one nation. Thanks to Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, he unified India from 550 princely states to one union of India. And you should study his life also to understand what Chanakya is really, you know, because he got all 550 princely states together. So coming back, we need to understand in India, the ideal leader always had a spiritual base. So look at a few examples. Raja Ranjit Singh, you know, many of us know about him, but he's not respected as a Raja. He's respected as a person with a lot of spiritual values. So many great kings, be it the Mysore Maharaja, be it the Maharajas of Travancore, all of them had a lot of spiritual base. Let me quote this. If you please study the Travancore model, because I'll tell you, it is one of the richest temples in the world, the Padmanabhat Swami Kshetram. It was under the control of the kings, but they never touched it. Even before 1947, they never touched it, okay? Because they believed that the wealth belongs to the people and the Raja is only a custodian. See, you are the wealthiest person having so much treasury. Even today, you cannot count how much it is there. You have to understand you are in power, you are in wealth, yet you have to be detached. And that's why Chanakya calls Raja Rishi. In fact, Shivaji Maharaj, another great leader, okay, he was called by his guru, Samartha Ramdas, as Srimanta Yogi. It's a great statement. What does it mean? Srimanta means prosperous, wealthy, powerful, but yogi. Bahar se, you are Srimanta, andar se, you are a yogi. Bahar se Raja, andar se Rishi. So, my dear friends, future leaders of India, the thinkers of Think India Leadership Forum, remember, getting into the power position is not leadership. Okay? What do you do after getting the power is real leadership. Unfortunately, leadership is a power game, but reality is that it should be an opportunity for service. So, once you get the power, you have all the resources and people under your command, but do you use it or misuse it? And that's why when you become a leader, I'm not telling you how to become a leader. That's a different ball game. My question is that what do you do after you become a leader? Yes, that's where Chanakya comes in. To become a leader, many people can manipulate also. In fact, many people don't understand the difference between strategy and manipulation. And Chanakya is known as a manipulator. Kootiniti. No. See, remember, in the power game, it's a different ball game altogether. And that's why, I mean, if you look at different parts of the world also, not only India, okay? If you look at the people with values, with commitment to the service of the society, is the one who are valued, Abraham Lincoln. Look at him. He's also a Raja Rishi in his own way, you know? If you look at Nelson Mandela, another great leader from another part of the world. So anywhere you, this whole concept of a leader having a philosophical base and spiritual base is India's contribution to the world. So all of you, congratulations. You will become leaders. We are Think India Forum. But my question is that after becoming a leader, don't forget these five things which I'm going to talk about. And Chanakya trains the leaders in these five aspects. In fact, I would put it the reverse way. If you understand these five, leadership is a cakewalk. But if you don't understand these five things, please learn it. So what are the five things? This is a summary of, okay, so 180 topics, so many areas. But Chanakya says a leader should be minimum trained in understanding five things. First, people should understand, or leaders should understand, principles of leadership. ओके सो व्हाट इज प्रिंसिपल. लोगों को लगता है कि लीडर बन गए. नो 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 नो, देयर आर प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ लीडरशिप. लाइक यू हैव नेचुरल लॉस इजंट इट. सो व्हेन अ साइंटिस्ट इज वर्किंग, ही इज वर्किंग ऑन नेचुरल लॉस इजंट इट. सो यू अंडरस्टैंड हाउ द नेचर वर्क्स. सो लीडरशिप के भी प्रिंसिपल्स होते हैं. लाइक यू नो इफ यू डू एमबीए देयर इज समथिंग कॉल्ड एज प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ मैनेजमेंट. सो देयर आर सो मेनी प्रिंसिपल्स. सो चाणक्य सेज यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड द प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ लीडरशिप. And today, if you look at leadership as becoming an academic discipline of study also. At Mumbai University, we have a leadership science as a degree, like management as a science, theories of leadership. And what does Chanakya say? Study all the past leaders, all the past theories of leadership. देखो कोई भी फील्ड में आप काम करते हो, रिसर्च करते हो, you will find there were experts in that field before you also, isn't it? So Einstein is not the first scientist. Or the first person who mastered physics. He studied the physics of the past, understood the theory, and then created his own theory. Isn't it? So initially, you have role models, but later on, you become a role model. So pehle aap logon ke case studies padhte ho, then later on, you become a case study. This is what Modi ji ka example hai. You know, he talks about previous leaders, but now he's become a role model for many of the leaders. So remember, if you want to be a leader, intelligence. कैसे बुद्धि को विकास करना है. हाउ डू यू बिकम इंटेलिजेंट? बाय स्टडी स्टडी स्टडी. एंड आवर इंडियन कल्चर टॉक्स अबाउट स्वाध्याय स्व अध्याय. स्टडी योर स्क्रिप्चर्स. सो चाणक्य कोट्स मोर देन 14 प्रीवियस लीडरशिप गुरुज इन हिज ओन अर्थशास्त्र. सो ही वॉज अ लीडरशिप गुरु, राजगुरु. बट ही टॉक्स अबाउट शुक्राचार्य, बृहस्पति, भीष्माचार्य, भीम, नारद, शांडिल्य. So Chanakya is not India's first leadership guru. We had a parampara of leadership. So you should be proud that this country always created leaders. Please understand this, that it is not the form of governance that matters, like monarchy or, you know, democracy. You decide what the form is. But the principles that the leaders follow matters a lot. That's why our civilization has crossed more than 5-10,000 years, isn't it? Because every time we selected the right leader, not elected the leader. India's parampara of leadership is selection, not election. Because election is manipulation. You have only one quality, and that is to understand vote bank strategy. But Chanakya says, you may get the chair, but are you capable of, you know, running the country after sitting on the chair? I like to quote Swami Chinmayananji. I've been part of Chinmaya Mission since my childhood. So he used to tell, you know, you may get the chair because of so many reasons, maybe because of dynasty. Your father was a leader, or maybe, you know, so you may become a leader because of dynasty, maybe because of your influence, or maybe some people have this whole quality of, you know, oratorship. Achha achha speeches denge. So you may have all the different methods, or maybe by bribing somebody. You never know, seed mil jata hai. So you may become a leader through so many methods and get the chair. But remember, he said, if you are not capable, the chair will not keep you. So kurchi milne tak is one journey, but after sitting on the kurchi, what to do is a different journey. So my dear friends, all leaders should not worry about getting the chair. It's the other way around. What will you do after you get the chair? Remember these five things. In fact, if you get a chair and if you're not delivering, next time koi aapko wapas nahi bulayega. Many people ask me, you know, how to become a leader. So don't become a leader. Develop the leadership qualities. You will be invited to become a leader. Yes, remember this. It is not about becoming a leader. It is developing the qualities and the thoughts of a leader. You will be invited with a red carpet welcome. Mind this. And I can give you my own example. I'm not even, you know, saying that I'm a great scholar, but by the grace of God, Mumbai University invited me to start an institute. Apply nahi kiya. Bhagwan ne supply kiya. So for all those people who want to power politics and wonder, you know, mujhe seat kabhi milega. Don't worry about seat kab milega. Kaam karo. लीडरशिप और कुर्ची आपके पास आएगी. आई एम टेलिंग यू दिस, दिस ऑल प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ लीडरशिप. बिकम केपेबल. लीडरशिप इज अ रिक्वायरमेंट. इनफैक्ट यू नो इफ यू हैव टू लुक इट फ्रॉम अ स्पिरिचुअल स्टैंड पॉइंट ऑल्सो, इट इज सेड भगवान अपना काम करने के लिए अच्छे हाथ ढूंढते रहता है. ओके, सो इवन गॉड वॉन्ट्स गुड पीपल टू डू हिज वर्क, बट वी आर नॉट रेडी. सो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू बी अ लीडर, बिकम रेडी फ्रॉम इनसाइड. अंदर से राजा बनो, बाहर से राजा बनी जाओगे. So if you know how to become a leader from inside, you know, some of my students say, sir, leader banne ke liye jigar lagta hai. Ha, josh lagta hai, but hosh bhi lagta hai. So yes, we can do it. But Chanakya also talks about how. So the principles is very important. Study different theories of leadership. And, you know, there are so many books available today. Everybody writing on leadership. There are seminars. Good. Isko kehte hai siddhanta. Try to understand what are the principles of leadership. And you should study. But Chanakya says, wait. Only theory is not enough. You should be practical. Chanakya was a practical philosopher. So after studying the principles of leadership, the theories of leadership, second is to understand economics. Artha Vyavastha, a leader, if he doesn't know how to understand the economic models, then he or she will be a failure. Okay? Very clear. Artha eva pradhana iti kautilyaha. Artha is wealth. Okay? Artha is also called as power. Artha is resources. A leader has to be a wealth creator. I have written a book called Chanakya and the Art of Getting Rich. You know, we Indians are very emotional. We like money, but we don't like to, you know, talk about money. Please understand, Chanakya is not making you money minded, but he's making you money conscious. Kaam karne ke liye paisa lagta hai. Goes to the extent of selling. Dharmasya moolam arthaha. Dharma ka kaam karne ke liye bhi artha lagta hai. See, very practical, no? Very practical. You know, everybody wants to do dharma activity, but no artha, nothing to donate. And today, fortunately, you will see that in India, the economic situations are changing and therefore people are donating more. Imagine in a poor nation, if you want to do good work also, there is no money. In fact, I remember I was called for a meeting and one Sadhu Maharaj, you know, I really love him for what he said. Bahut bada conference tha and saying that, you know, we have to preserve our country's culture and all those things. He got up and said, listen, please create money and the culture will be protected. Oh, then he's real Chanakya. This Babaji, exactly understand. See, we have been left as a very poor and malnutritioned nation since 1947. So the last 75 years, we only working on our economic model. Isn't it true? And that is right, you know, whichever party, whatever it is, we were just trying to now becoming a economically sustainable model. Fortunately, that one step is over. Artha Vyavastha thodi theek ho gayi hai, but no, Chanakya says you have to maintain it. Okay, first create wealth, then manage wealth. That's very, very important. In fact, there are a lot of principles. I will not go into detail about wealth. In fact, I'm doing a program. If somebody is wanting to attend, I will send you the details. It's called Chanakya's Economic Theories and the Art of Creating Wealth. Okay, I've written a book, as I told you. So some other time we'll talk about it, but it's very important. Even if you have made money, you should know how to manage money and sustain it. That's why if you look at a country like America, okay, we're already economically number one, but you know, they maintain it, they sustain it. And Chanakya says about kosha. Kosha means treasury of a kingdom. He says the treasury should not be full. It should be overflowing. Aapko 100 rupiya chahiye, 100 rupiya mila, kaun si badi baat hai? Okay, aapke paas 500 rupiya ho to, then your mind thinks differently, isn't it? Saying that, okay, my need is 100 rupees, but if I got 400 rupees extra, I can do a lot of good activities. I can donate it. I can create more entrepreneurs. So economics is very important for leadership. So please study economics, not as theory, okay? Theory ho gaya, principles of economics. But the principles of leadership is practical economics. And my here warning to all the intelligent students over here is that theory economics and practical economics are totally opposite, not different. Okay, because you have to understand what is happening in the marketplace. You have to understand what is a parallel economy that exists. I'm not only talking about black money. Okay, there is a parallel economics. For example, okay, the house is actually run by the lady of the house, isn't it? So ma ke paas jo savings hai na, that is a real economy. Not pitaji kya kamata hai. Pitaji jo kamata hai wo incoming hai, the traditional model. But the savings of the mother is a real economy, and it comes out during crisis. So you have to understand, you study all these GDP models and this and that. Okay, it is good. Okay, but what is the real thing? Why is India able to survive all the economic ups and downs? Because the lady of the house thinks about the family. And she's got a secret account the husband also doesn't know. So this is called practical economics. Okay, so I would say that, you know, Chanakya has this great sense of understanding what is a real economy. Not only calculating the macro level, theoretical model. Theory is important. But, you know, he went into micromanagement of understanding how the economic model works. And of course, he knew how to collect taxes. So the model, I just simplify it for you. People should pay the taxes. It's a duty of a praja. Hamare yahan pe tax ki chori praja se hi shuru hoti hai. So leadership chodo. We don't have followership also. So a follower in this country, how much percentage actually gives taxes? And all rich people, let me put the word, all rich people have chartered accountants. And you know what they use a chartered accountant for? How not to pay taxes. Please understand this. Without taxes, how will the economy run? First of all, people don't want to pay taxes. And if the taxes are paid, the government doesn't use it for the welfare of the people. So cycle, log tax dete nahi hai, and government usko kharcha karti nahi hai. Where is the problem? Leadership. So people are paying taxes honestly. It is your duty to give back the taxes for the welfare of the people. It's a complete cycle, isn't it? Who are the wealth creators? The entrepreneurs, the businessmen, isn't it true? So wealth creators should pay taxes, but they don't have faith in the government. Actually speaking, they don't have faith in the leader. Okay, so pay the taxes, then the government should make schemes to get that taxes back to the society, to the same people. And that's why there's a very beautiful formula. Some of you must have heard about it. How should the king collect taxes from the people? As the honeybee collects honey from the flower. You know, honeybee goes to every flower, takes little. It doesn't disturb the flower. It doesn't destroy the flower. And the flower is happy, saying that thoda thoda leke jao. The honey comb is full. Okay? And people are happy giving little. In fact, our real economic model is temple economy. You don't even understand this. If you go to every little village, okay, it is self-sufficient because it is based on temple economy. It is called Grama Devata. We have Kula Devata and Grama Devata. And all villages have a temple. Isn't it true? So when Gandhiji says India lives in villages, it is not an economic statement. It's a cultural ecosystem. And gaon mein koi bhi activity hoti hai. Pehle Grama Devata ka darshan. Shadi bhi wahan pe hogi. Decisions bhi wahan pe hoga. Every discussion is happening over there. So it's the unit. And remember, the treasury of the temple is a social responsibility. Isn't it true? So I give you one example of a Grama Devata. Thiruvananthapuram. Grama Devata kumsa hai Padmanabhak Swami Kshetram. That whole thing is a treasury of the whole Grama. So every particular temple of India has got a treasury. Isn't it true? And that has to be useful for the people. Anyway, I will not get into the discussion in detail, but what I'm telling you that if you want a leader, you should understand economic model of this country along with the economic models of the other countries, because we are all interconnected world. As everything is digitized, the world is flat, everything is valued by, you know, the US dollars. India, when it got freedom, $1 is equal to 1 rupees. Pata nahi abhi 70-80 kaise ho gaya. So all you thinkers decide, where is the loophole? We may earn a lot, but valuation kuch nahi hai. So a lot of people say, you know, this is like this and we have signed some agreements. I don't know. But what I'm saying is very clearly, if 1 is equal to 80, there is something fundamentally wrong. How to correct it? You thinkers, the future leaders of India should think, get the economy under control. And economic under control is actually the total control. Jisne economy ko control kar liya, usne sahi mein sab kuch control kar liya. See, Chanak is very... He is a practical philosopher and a practical economist. So leaders should not be only theory based. Achha padhai kariya, principles of economics done. But when you go to the vyavahar, the real transaction, you should know. Okay. But remember, the base is ethical and spiritual. Raja Rishi. Well, smart guys make a lot of money. But the question is for whom? Apne liye aur apne parivar ke liye. People only talk about parivar. Huh? And we say Vasudeva Kutumbakam. But we never give our money to our neighbor. One of the most selfish thing that we can do is earn money for I, myself, and maximum my family. So you know what is the limitation of family? Not Vasudeva Kutumbakam. My family means my wife, my child, two sons, and thoda meherbani ho gaya to thoda sa apna bhai behan le thoda abhi. If you want money, create it with hard work. At the same time, give it back to the whole world. So we have to relook at the whole thing. So that's why I think I request Think India Leadership Forum to look at Indian economic models. Already great people like, you know, our own economists, many of them are working, Vaidyanathan sir, you know, all this. So I'm sure you will get all of them over here. But, you know, Indian economic model is answer for India. The world economic model is answer for the West. So their model has to be corrected. I'm not telling you to be against them, but what I'm saying is that study them and make an Indian model, isn't it? Because our culture is different, our value systems are different. So Chanakya says, second thing a leader should know is practical economics. The third thing, very, very interesting, a leader should know is law, okay? Because everything is governed by law. When India got freedom, You know who got freedom for us? The lawyers. It is actually the lawyers who studied in Britain, okay, went over there, studied it, and came back and said, okay, legally, please go out. Gandhiji was a lawyer. Nehru was a lawyer. Ambedkar was a lawyer. Isn't it true? And for that matter, even Jinnah was a lawyer. Understand one thing, that if you want to be a leader, you should understand how law. Of course, law in India is called as dharma. Okay, and there are different levels of law, you know, right from, you know, judiciary laws to bylaws to, of course, natural laws. Dharayati iti dharmaha. Okay, so you should understand the natural law. And if you understand the natural law, naturally, you will take care of your ecosystem and environment. Isn't it? Aapko alag se na koi dusri policy ki zarurat nahi hai. Unfortunately, what happens is that we have different laws for human, different laws for the mineral world and different laws for the world. Chanakya says, for a Raja, the whole ecosystem is his Praja. So Praja includes the mineral world and the plant world and the animal world. So your ecosystem, if you look at the fishermen community, okay, which are actually fishing and making the revenue out of it, they also know there are seasons in which you don't fish. Every festival in India is connected to nature. So we are a person who understand what is to work with nature and ecosystem. So don't think that, you know, we are not. But unfortunately, ours is only about manufacturing, GDP, all on paper, but not real economics. Chanakya goes to the extent of telling that wealth comes from the countryside. Okay? So hum log kya karte hai? Sare gaon wale shehar mein aake bas gaye. But real wealth is there. We are living in a city urbanization. But till the modern so-called manufacturing era, we were a country. Gaon mein jitna gaay aur jitna land, you are the richest person. Abhi pata nahi, Bombay mein, I said in Bombay, chota sa matchbox room, 2 crore rupees. What 2 crore rupees? You will live in a mansion. So you have to understand one thing. Somewhere we have to go back to the villages to understand the real wealth and create laws in a way that even the villager is protected. So of course, we have a lot of reforms happening at the public policy level. But you as a person should create new public policy. Please understand that you cannot just sit over there and say, kya kare, aisa ho gaya. Ho gaya to kya kare, change karo. So it is said that, you know, Swami Chinmayananji again quoted him, said, every generation has got two responsibilities. Every generation has got two responsibilities. One is to continue what is good of the past. You got a culture, we got a tradition, we have to continue. Usme achhi cheeze bhi hai. But discontinue what is not relevant. So we are all proud. We should also be proud. We should continue Chanakya and all those things. But there are certain social practices which are not good. It is your responsibility to stop them. Okay? So don't think. But you cannot stop them, you know, just because you feel. Sentiments is not enough to change the law. You should be sensible to change a law. Understand that big difference? It is not being sensitive. Of course, you have to be sensitive, but you cannot be sentimental. So, mujhe lagta hai. And dharana lene se kuch nahi hota. Okay, you can go out and become an activist. It is good. Everybody should be a little bit of an activist. It's good. Remember one thing, be active intellectually to create a new law if it is required. So, this understanding of law, dekhe, Article 370, bolo, ya whatever, isn't it all happening through a legal process? Through a parliamentarian process, and then you say, wow, because aap kuch bhi karo. If the law will stop you, then you're stuck. Understand the law, change the law, and create new laws as per your requirement of your generation. And let me tell you, every generation requires its own set of new laws, isn't it true? But continue what is good. Aisa nahi ki everything of the past is bad, but certain things are irrelevant also. You should have the maturity of the leader to say that I respect my past, but I will adapt to the change that is required in the society. Third thing, study law, not just become a lawyer. I know many of you are from premium law institutes, but a lawyer is not just fighting a case, he's understanding the law and creating. I'll give you a simple example. I've co-written a book with D. Sivanandan, sir, a book called as Chanakya's 7 Secrets of Leadership. I would suggest all of you read that book. It's a good book where Bombay was totally under the control of the underworld. And you know, these underworld gundas are smart guys. So don't think that, you know, the gundas are not intelligent. They're also thinking. Well, of course, they're not thinking about India. They're not think India. But they're also thinkers. They know how to manipulate with Indian laws. That is how they become think Indians. And then when D. Sivanandan sir came, he realized one thing: the law itself is giving the power to the criminals. You know, the criminals know how to use and misuse the law through the lawyers. You know what he did? He created a new law. It's called MOCA. और उसी लॉ में ऐसा फंसा दिया कि everybody ran off from India. So even if you're a policeman, if you're a leader, you need to understand law and create new law. So Chanakya is saying, you know, the structure itself needs to be changed. Like how we have a constitution of India and it goes through amendments, isn't it? In the same way, if you think certain laws have to be written up, but strategically do it. The fourth thing that a leader should know is foreign policies. So don't be a leader only in one level, you know, be a world leader. And the word Chanakya uses is called Vijigishu. Vijigishu is the person who wants to be a world leader, local leader, then national leader, and then over. No. India has to be a global leader. And you, whichever field you should choose, you should be number one in that field. So you should know what works in my country, what works in the other country. So the policies that work in other country also you have to study. And today, with the internet era, I think you will know what's happening everywhere. So what is working in one country may not work in another country. So look at, you know, UN. What's happening at UN? What's happening? You know, we are not even getting an entry into that National Security Council, isn't it? And Modiji's speech, I really loved it. He said, you know, we deserve that place. Okay, we deserve it. It is not saying request mode pe nahi baat kiya unhone. You know, please, you know, we are also a nice country. Hum log ne bahut kaam kiya. It's a demand out of contribution. We deserve to be there to make a statement at the world level. Swami Vivekananda said this very nicely. Because Swami Vivekananda said, when the world sits for discussions of what is the future of this world, India has to give its voice. As in, you know, another 100 country, 120, 180 countries, more country. Hey, what one more country? We should be among the policy makers who have a say. All of you leaders, don't think like followers. Don't be arrogant either. But at the same time, you should have a say. And Swami Vivekananda very clearly said, when the world is losing direction, India will give the world a spiritual direction. Okay, so don't just be, you know, aajkal school mein hota hai, I sometimes get called for that. You know, what is a model United Nations? Have you heard about all that? The discussion. But I say, model United Nations is not about winning a prize. I got a lot of people have in the CV, you know, I have participated in 200 model United Nations. But real United Nations mein jao, model hi khatam ho jaye. So study the foreign policies, foreign trade, how things are happening, and stand up for something. If you don't stand for something, you will fall for everything. If you don't stand up for something, you will fall for everything. Leadership is standing for something which you believe is important. And the fifth and the last point is understand war, competition. Main bahut achha leader hu. But compared to whom? That is a very good question. And leadership, you know, position is one, aspirants are many. It's a demand and supply problem in leadership. The problem is that too many aspirants and only one kurchi, what to do? So sometimes you have to be smarter than the competition. Okay? And Chanakya says, never fight a battle alone, take some friends along. So if you have understanding of how the competition thinks, you can defeat the competition. So you have to build strategic thinking. Of course, the most famous theory of Chanakya is Samadana Dandabheda. You heard about it? So it doesn't work like this. And remember another one, enemy is a friend. So if you have to tackle one, you have to look at his neighbor, like how we are using Japan to counterbalance the China issue. Isn't it true? It's all people to even study one particular part of Chanakya's theories. It's called Mandala theory. It comes in the Arthashastra. It's called the circle of kings. How do you become a world leader? Because when you are going to win the game, there'll be a lot of competition. Isn't it true? So friends, I want to just wind up with these 5 points and summarize it, and then we'll go for Q&A. If you want to be a leader, andar se raja bano. And what is the quality? Raja Rishi. A Raja Rishi who is guided by a Raj Guru. Okay, so I have some mentors also who will tell you what to do and what to do. So what are the 5 things? Principles of management. Read a lot about leadership. What are the models working in other countries, other industries also for principles of management. Second is understand economics. Artha eva pradhana hi tikautilya. If you don't understand artha vyavahar, you will not understand leadership. Third, please understand law. Understand law, but if required, create a new law. And fourth thing, foreign policies. You have to be very smart in understanding how the world thinks and navigate your way to become a world leader. Vijigishu. And the fifth one is competition, war, how to handle the competition and become a winner in the war. like to just stop over here by quoting something which is very famous in the Indian Armed Forces, and I'm very fortunate to work with them very closely. It is said, battles are not fought in the battlefield. It is fought in the minds of the generals. वो युद्ध के मैदान में युद्ध नहीं होता, यहाँ पे होता है. So friends, all of you become a leaders over here, okay? And you will become a real leader the way Chanakya wanted. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir. I'm so encouraged to hear all that you share, and I have just notes full in my notebook, and I just loved all these points. Now I will request that we move to the Q&A session, and I'll request all other members over here that either you can post your queries in the chat window, or you may also want, you can also turn your microphone on and ask sir directly. So okay, we have something in the chat window. So Swapnil wants to ask that the strategies to collapse the timeline in the process of climbing the ladder to reach the pinnacle in quick time in a strategic and smart way. So how can we climb the ladder of leadership in a quick and in a strategic and smart way?
Very nice question. Okay, so strategy and smartness, two S along with one more S, spirituality, is important for leadership. See, now let me talk about all the three. Okay? So smartness is very, very important. Okay? So as they say, you know, don't work hard, work smart. But how do you become smart? Learn from the mistakes of others and take advice from those people who have walked the path before you. आपको सारी गलतियां खुद नहीं करनी चाहिए, जो गलती कर चुके हैं उनसे सीखना चाहिए. Smartness is not doing it yourself, is learning from those who have done it before you. So that's how you have an advantage of time. Let's say, for example, you know, my father is a businessman, okay, and he's created 100 crores. I don't have to start from zero. I can learn from my dad how 25, 30 years he created 100 crores. But I can create that 100 crores in my business in maybe 10 years. So that's called smart learning. Okay, now strategy. How do you become strategic in nature? And that step is study. See, strategy comes from very deep thinking. Insightful thinking, foresightful thinking. You should be able to see the future. You should be able to see the direction. So that is what the modern, lot of good schools talk it like a system of case studies. So a strategy cannot be yours, you know. Strategy is depending on a lot of factors like different situations, who is the competitor, what is the situation. So you have to learn. It is called professional upgrading before you become a strategic thinker. Let me give you an example of a great strategic thinker from India and a leader. His name is Field Marshal Manekshaw. I know about him, how in 1971 he split, you know, Bangladesh separately from Pakistan. So it is said about him that Indira Gandhi was the prime minister at that time and saying that, you know, this Bangladesh problem and this and that, people are infiltrating, go and stop them. And Field Marshal Manekshaw just said, you know, this is not the right time. He was very angry at that particular time, isn't it? Because when a prime minister is giving an order, you better listen. But he was smart and he was strategic. He went and told, hey, madam, aapko kya karna hai? Jeetna hi hai na? Or you want to face the other problem which your dad faced. Remember Tibet? So it was the wrong timing. So you know, I exactly, you know, give me some time, give me a few months, I will deliver the results for you. And you see that Field Marshal Manekshaw just had to wait for the season change. He did not do it impulsively. Even though the order came from the top, he said, no, no, give me time. And he delivered the results. Isn't it true? So remember one, you should be smart and you should know strategy, how to communicate also. But the third S is also equally important. You have a spiritual way. You know what? Same thing, smartness and strategy could be for selfish reason. But great leaders know it is for not for me. It is for the praja sukha. It is for the welfare of others. Field Marshal Manekshaw retired and he never even looked back. Okay. Therefore, one of the things is that if you don't have a spiritual base, you will think strategically and smartly, but you will become selfish. Good leaders should not have a selfish interest, but they should be purposeful. Isliye Bhagavad Gita ka concept, it says very nicely, don't have your own personal benefit in that, you know. Hey, what is in it for me? What is in it for me? So you say, you know, don't expect a result. But that doesn't mean you're not working, okay? Nishkam. Nishprayog. Nishkam matlab, I don't want anything. आई डोंट हैव अ पर्सनल निष्काम, बट निष्प्रयोग नहीं होना चाहिए. व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ प्रयोजन? यू शुड हैव अ प्लान. डोंट सिट ओवर देयर एंड हैव नो प्लान. सो बी स्मार्ट स्ट्रेटेजिक विद अ स्पिरिचुअल बेस. यू विल डेफिनेटली विन द वॉर. थैंक यू.
Thank you, sir. Our next question is from Akshay, and he asks that what are the key features for a leader at student level?
At student level?
Yes.
Excellent. You know, please take initiatives. Okay. So don't wait for somebody to tell you, you know, so it's very important that you should be initiative taker. So don't just wait, observe something. And the good part is that there is a leadership requirement everywhere. Okay. So don't wait for student and say, you know, I am the chairman of the committee, I'm the president of the committee. That is formal leadership. But a lot of people get appointed as a chairman, but they don't do anything. You start doing first. Okay. So what I'm saying that as a student in your area, in your college, your university, just look out for problem and take an initiative. It could be just as simple as, you know, maybe a crowdfunding or maybe collecting students for Think India platform. That's also leadership. Is it? But let me tell you, जोश में होश मत खोना. पीपल स्टार्ट करते हैं कैसे पता नहीं. सो दैट्स व्हाई चाणक्य कम्स इन. ओके. सो इट इज सेड दोस पीपल हु स्टार्ट ओके विदाउट प्लानिंग आर कॉल्ड एज आरंभे शूराः. आरंभ विद लॉट ऑफ जोश, कम ऑन कम ऑन, बट आफ्टरवर्ड्स आफ्टर वन सीजन गॉन. सो यू नो व्हाट वी रिक्वायर एज स्टूडेंट्स इज दैट यू नो यू शुड थिंक बिफोर यू डू एंड आफ्टर यू डू यू थिंक. थिंक इंडिया, राइट? So if you develop leadership qualities in your college, take initiatives with proper planning. In fact, you know, if you follow me on Twitter, I'll teach you the strategies of how to take initiative. Currently, I'm talking about project management on my Twitter. You can follow me on R. Chanakya Pillai, you know, Ganesh sir, you can give the thing. So I'm actually teaching strategies. So as students, I would say that think about it, plan about it, do it, get the results and repeat it. So if you're successful in one project, don't stop over there. Okay, repeat the next. And I'll tell you, everybody will notice you. Her project may successful hai, project, but keep repeating it. And I'll tell you, believe me, after you, your student days are also over, the leader in you will only evolve. I remember, I think it was Nitin Gadkari ji or one of those ministers, he says, you know, the leaders are actually born in colleges, but executed at the national level. So this is your field. This is your ground. So be a leader at the student level. Be like Chanakya, who was a good student, learn strategies, take initiatives, but yaad rakhega, josh mein hosh mat kholna. Okay? So hosh and strategy will make you a great student leader. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. So like that's like we should always try to be patient and also be persistent. And that's what even Swapnil is asking as he asks about the importance of persistence in order to achieve a certain goal. So moving to the next question is, it is by Sarthak, where he's asking the fundamental difference between Sun Tzu theory and Chanakya ideology.
Sun Tzu and War. Okay, that's a very famous book. So Chanakya is compared to two people. One is Sun Tzu and the Art of War. He's a Chinese general. And the second comparison is Machiavelli and the Prince. Okay, so generally people say, you know, Machiavelli, Chanakya is a Machiavelli of India. Wrong comparison. And Sun Tzu and the Art of War is what Chanakya also spoke about. Now, since you asked this question, let me tell you, I have actually, I don't know whether I can show you. Let me see whether I have a copy of it. Okay, so good. So I have it right now in front of you. Sun Tzu and the Art of War. Okay. Now, interestingly, I don't know whether I can show you this. If you can read this below, okay, you can see the screen. It says that I've written a foreword for this book. Okay. So the interesting part is that your question is directly answered here. It's a publication by Hatchape. And I've studied this and I realized one thing. It says forwarded by Radhakrishnan Pillai, best-selling author of Corporate Chanakya. So Art of War I've studied, but given a Chanakya dimension, okay? Why am I telling you this? I'm not trying to market this book. But after studying this book, the publishers realized one thing. Are there Chanakya strategies and art? Yes. So I want to tell you this one thing. All that these people are saying is already included in Arthashastra. So ऐसा कहते हैं महाभारत के बारे में, they said about महाभारत, what व्यासा wrote, everybody else only cut, copied and pasted. So you have to understand one thing, that everything that we talk about is already there in our Indian scriptures. So I would respect the art of war because he was a military general and you should learn from every culture. You have nothing wrong. So study this if you want. But the whole idea is that I don't find anything great and new about it. Because if you study Chanakya, it's like, you know, you already passed 10th standard. Now you're going to go and study in the 4th standard. So you have to understand one thing, this comparison is coming from the West because they got introduced of the war first and then Chanakya comes in, isn't it? So it's called the first mover advantage. But the reality is that Chanakya is bigger and smarter. And there's a lot of comparison, of course, it's all there. But I want to tell you, be it the Prince Machiavelli or the Art of War, Chanakya has exceeded them and included them in his teachings. Study, but be proud about Chanakya also. And study Chanakya also. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. The next question is from Jayant Mandal, and he's asking about the childhood of Chanakya, as to what environment created who he is in the future.
Yeah. Let me be clear that I'm not a historian, okay? But I am a person who tried to study the life of Chanakya, and I've seen many, many different versions of Chanakya's life, okay? But I can give you a few ideas that he was born in Pataliputra, which is very clear, and his father's name was Acharya Chanak. Okay, so Acharya Chanak. So his father was also a political teacher. And in India, we have to understand dynasty has its own advantages also. Okay. Agar doctor ka beta, achha doctor bana. Remember the word achha doctor. Not just doctor ka beta, doctor bana. So in the same way, Raja ka beta bhi achha Raja nikla. Achha hai na? This is a capability. Like, you know, Dashrath had 4 good kings as his children. So coming back, Chanakya's father was also a teacher of Arthashastra. Okay. So the childhood is very clear that his father was his first guru. His first political teacher was his father himself. The second thing is that it is said that he went to Takshashila University, where he studied from Patna, that is Pataliputra. He went to Takshashila, there he became a brilliant teacher, and he comes back. But there are also stories which say that, you know, probably Chanakya did not have a great childhood because his father was against the rule of Dhananand, who was then the ruler of Pataliputra or the Magadha dynasty. And he had a public uprising, and the king Dhananand got so angry that he actually killed Chanakya's father. Chanakya's father was called as Acharya Chanak, and the Jain scriptures called as Acharya Chini. So I don't know which is the real name, but Chanakya, some people say, had to flee. Khudka jaan bacha ke he, and he came back as a young boy with strategy and, you know, smartness to dethrone the same Dhananand. So the life of Chanakya in childhood, he was known as Vishnugupta. Okay, Vishnugupta Kautilya Chanakya. And he was a brilliant student before he became a brilliant teacher. So these are some of the things that I know about his childhood. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. The next question is from me. I was just having this query as to, as young leaders, what kind of spiritual or mindfulness practices should we do to develop leadership qualities?
So two things very, very, very clearly, okay, please practice it. 20 minutes of meditation every day, okay? Now you can decide which form of meditation you want to do, whether it's Vipassana ho, ya Shri Shri Ravi Shankar ji as a Sudarshan Kriya, then there are Vedantic forms of meditation, Sadguruji has got inner engineering, yeah, so many. So I'm not talking about the form of meditation, but whatever you say, 20 minutes, if you can sit quietly, asana sthira, okay, with a stable body, watch your breath, because finally after asana, Patanjali Yoga Sutra also takes you to pranayama. Okay, so sit quietly, watch your breath, because the mind and the body has got a connection through the breath. Isn't it true? So first thing I would say is that irrespective of whatever background, culture, religion, tradition you belong to, meditation is a basic requirement. Today we call it mindfulness, coming from the West, isn't it? Mind your mind. Okay. So 20 minutes every day you have to study. And minimum 10 minutes every day, please study a scripture. I don't know what scripture you like, but there are so many in India, Upanishads, Bhagavad Gita, Ramayana, Mahabharata, Arthashastra. Okay. So if your daily routine, if you can give half an hour, ideally you should give more, but I'm giving you minimum 20 minutes of quiet meditation and 20 minutes of studying a scripture. One shloka from maybe Mahabharata, Ramayana, Gita, you decide that. Believe me, it's like exercising for 20 minutes and getting onto the world for a marathon. And let me tell you, दिस स्पिरिचुअल अंदर से जब तैयार होकर आप जाते हो, व्हेन यू आर रेडी फ्रॉम इनसाइड स्पिरिचुअली, यू विल फेस एनी प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ द वर्ल्ड. ओके, सो दिस टू एक्सरसाइजेस यू शुड डू इज मेडिटेट फॉर 20 मिनट्स एंड ऑफ कोर्स स्टडी फॉर 10 मिनट्स एंड देन यू आर रेडी फॉर द डे. आई स्टडी एंड मेडिटेट फॉर 3 आवर्स अ डे इवन टूडे. यस, एंड माई फादर इज 85 years old, ही मेडिटेट्स फॉर 10 आवर्स अ डे. I'm not telling you to go to that extreme because you have to do better things now. But meditation and scriptural study is a must for every young boy or girl who is in the youth. And as you mature, the timing also should increase. Thank you.
Just to add to that question, why do you say that it is a must? What is the benefit of being grounded in spirituality or strong in spirituality for a leader?
Very, very, very good question. I'm impressed by the question. Do you take a bath every day?
Yes.
Do you brush your teeth every day?
Yes.
Why? Because you start realizing if you don't do that, you will not have a problem. Others will have a problem. Okay. So now think about it. Your physical body level, you take a bath, you clean up yourself, wear a nice dress and interact with the people. But do you prepare your mind before you face the world? Okay. So I think we have not been used to train our inner self. So as you clean your body outside, what do you do for cleaning your mind inside? So andar se bhi snan karna chahiye na thoda sa. So when you interact with people, you don't have those negative qualities. You know, there are certain people, when they come physically, you don't like them, isn't it? Because they smell a lot. Snan nahi kiya. But reverse it. A person who comes with a lot of greed, anger, you like that person? No. You say, you know, this person, usse dur raho. Because somewhere he may be very beautifully dressed, handsome or beautiful. But the qualities is, you know, kama, krodha, lobha, moha, madha, matsari, isn't all the negative qualities. No, no, no. Ye bekar aadmi hai. He said, dur raho. If you want to be good from inside. Remember, swachhata from outside and pavitrata from inside. Okay, so andar se thoda pure hona chahiye. And meditation and spiritual sadhana gives you that. Because when a leader is going out to the public, he cannot only dress nicely, okay? But you should have a pure heart to connect to people. That is what Raja Ram is all about. When Raja Ram went, people wanted not only to see his alankar, jewelry kitna acha pehna, you know, aaj Modi ji ne kaun sa dress pehna hai, photo. That is all okay. But you know, you should also know if he's not pure from inside, he will not communicate rightly. So, bahar se agar aap brush karte ho, snan karte ho, andar se bhi thoda kar lo, aadha ghanta. That's why spirituality, meditation, reading the scriptures, satsang, all these are important to develop and clean the person from inside. Clean from outside, pure from inside. That's great leadership, Raja Rishi. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. On that note, I would like to conclude the Q&A session over here. And I would say, what a great start we have had to the leadership forum with such a great discussion on Chanakya's theory on leadership. Thank you so much, sir, on behalf of the entire Think India team, on behalf of Ganesh, sir, and on also behalf of on Medhavi ji, I would like to thank you a lot for being here today and really enlightening all of us with such a great wisdom and knowledge. Thank you so much.
Thank you all. Thank you, Medhavi. Thank you, Ganesh ji. Thank you, Ram.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.